Now you're working with some ass, eh? Your bad, eh? Make a nigga spend his cash, eh? His last, eh? Hold round with your pass, eh? They mad, eh? You can ride in the Jag, eh? With that, eh? You can smoke up by your bag, eh?
Hello, and welcome back to the Lots to Unpack podcast, episode 4. I'm Gelby, here with D.L.
Yeah, it was very funny because we were sitting here recording for like 2 minutes and then you just went, I wasn't expecting that. I mean, we're just sort of sitting.
I went right into
talking,
it.
Talking, and yes, you went right into
it. I get into game mode.
Also, live audience here today, we have both Naftali, who's hosting us for the third consecutive time. Thank you, Naftali.
Welcome to the Lots to Unpack podcast, brought to you by
Rivervale Orthodontics. Thank you, Adar. I know her
Wasserman.
Adar Wasserman, but I think her dental name is Adar Finkel.
Adar Finkel, Adar Finkel Wasserman.
Also,
excellent orthodontist. Please,
also,
for all your teeth needs.
I'm speaking. Also, our first sponsor, Casey Lerner, will be going to Adar's orthodontic to practice tomorrow because she broke her. She has an inside retainer thing that is something, but yeah. Also, I am a known now customer through my family of Rivervale Orthodontics,
as all you should be.
If you need braces, if you need retainers, if you need anything from an orthodontist, she is your girl. She is a sweetheart, and so is her husband, Alex Wasserman, known very, very close friend of mine.
Sorry, just contacting one of our call-ins that will be coming later.
Already?
Well, he's asked if we're on time, so we are on time.
We're on time. It's 9:27.
Close enough. And then our next sponsor for this episode is Dan Schluffman.
Dan Schluffman, thank
Schluffman
you very much.
Real Estate Law and Home Financing.
Correct. Schluffman, thank you very much. I believe he has sponsored 2 episodes.
He has. Thanks for killing the surprise for the next episode. But
correct.
Yes.
But so we will thank him today, and we will
we'll
also
thank him
next week on our episode. Speaking of sponsors, you wanted to thank our former sponsor,
Twillery.
They sponsored us once,
but they provided excellent
clothes. I was
against
this in principle
because
they sponsored one episode, and then
Lerner wants more clothes. But
no,
I got enough clothes.
It was actually you said if we bring them up
and
again,
we could get more. I've
said,
already gotten a bunch.
I said no. So we will thank our old sponsor Twillery, but they will not be mentioned again.
But the promo code LTU18 still works for $18 off orders of $139 or more.
Twillery knows those are $20 at least for that. It's another 20 glove.
All right, with that, let's get into this week's action, or I guess it's 2 weeks' action because we were off last week. We'll start with a lot of interesting things going on in the gold bracket. We're almost done with pool play.
Very long. Can we discuss
it's been
the
very
length
long.
Of
it's been
this?
Very long.
It's like I'm falling asleep
one,
in the chat. I'm falling asleep
absolutely.
In the tournament. It's a little bit too long.
One of
out.
Many failures of Ayatollah.
There's an Ayatollah?
That's what Panuski calls it. Ayatollah Komeklis.
Let it be known, Jason Panuski.
Ayatollah Chad Komeklis.
Yeah, this could be true. Also found
many
out
failures.
That there's not a single Shabbat dinner in the Englewood contingent that the Ayatollah has not spoken about. Known thing within the Englewood Teaneck community for us Tenafly people, there is never.
Honestly, I think that has spread to Teaneck. He is spoken about in Teaneck quite often as well.
I think that's right. He's also making the Tenafly rounds currently.
I think he's been spending more time on fourth grade girls basketball lately. Is that right?
He knows where his bread is buttered.
Englewood, correct.
Especially with girls' youth basketball. That's really where his bread is buttered. But yeah, it's been a very long one. But we've had our first surprise.
What are
surprise.
You drinking for our viewers?
Oh, this is compliments of our wonderful host.
We didn't ask who gave it to. We said,
well, I don't know what it is. I know it's tequila, but he likes to surprise me. Which one is this? Is this the Costco again?
Why are you shaming him like that?
No, it's good stuff.
Side note, I'm wearing shorts today. I've given up on like wearing any sort of. It's usually my roll-up
sweatpants. It's not a question of whether you're wearing shorts. It's whether your leg is shaking the entire episode.
Let me show them some leg.
And why are you wearing shorts?
Okay, I'm done.
We can get into. Are those high-cut shorts?
And why am I wearing shorts? There's many reasons why.
You need something that you can put on easily.
Throw
Casey Lerner Real Estate, let's go! Great sponsor. She sponsors this show, and thank you to Riverdale Orthodontics.
Rivervale. Riverdale is where I grew up. Nothing to do with orthodontics.
Correct. That's correct. Rivervale Orthodontics. Correct. All right. So what were we saying about the gold bracket? I don't remember any matches. You're going to have to prompt me.
Well, we've had some interesting developments. Number one I have is Bawa and Scotty H are eliminated.
Yeah. I didn't think that was so interesting. I know Chad did in his write-up, but I think that was predicted from day one that they had no chance. It was sort of, I think Chad wrote that as well, that it's just a tougher tournament this year. Hirschman, I said, I think on the last podcast, too heavy a lift. Although I was surprised. I thought Dan and John were a favorite on paper, but I didn't know if they have the mental fortitude. They certainly did have the mental fortitude after dropping down 6-love in the first set and 2-0 in the second set. Came back and had a big win in an elimination match.
By the way, Daniel and John, not on the tournament record sheet, but they had a fun match against Goyo and Ali G this past week on Friday. I put on the next court, and it was a beatdown. They destroyed Goyo and Ali G. Not a good sign for their prospects in the tournament.
I don't think that means anything. When you have two guys who are head cases, who can't deal with the nerves and they play a fun match, of course they're going to play well.
Oh, you're saying Roman and Carlin, you can't read anything
into
that.
Naftali thinks this is a live interactive event today. He's not called upon.
That's pretty spicy. He doesn't like to get spicy. This is pretty spicy for him.
You must come on the camera. By the way, let me just start the podcast. We're going to rewind 5 minutes. I was running Naftali over in pool today. And when I say running him over, I'm up 3-0. Technically, it was sort of like 4-0. You scratch with the white ball. He doesn't count a scratch when he's breaking as a loss. So,
I have a joke we might have to edit out, by the way. But...
So I go up 3-0, then he wins the game 3-1, which I could have won. Then he has one ball left. I'm on the 8 ball. I have the easiest shot in all of pool to go up 4-1. I brick it, shambles. He wins, so now it's 3-2. So let's start there. Hirschman and Bawa, your toast. All right, thank you for playing.
Thank you for playing.
See you next year.
Yeezys and Selby.
Yeezys and Selby. I'm so fucking proud of Selby. I fucking love that guy. Those two are playing great.
Do you think
ball.
They have a real shot in the tournament, other than the fact that you think you're going to beat everybody?
I do think I'm going to beat everybody. That happens.
If you
to be
take yourself out
although
of that,
if I play like I did on Saturday, which was the first time I played in 2 weeks, I will beat nobody. But I do think I will beat everyone with Bobby. He's playing great. Selby and Yessies have a chance. Everyone does. I mean, look what they're doing, running everyone over in their bracket.
So
cocky, though. Joey to a podcast.
Do you guys think Selby and Yessies have a real shot in the tournament?
Oh, they're shaking their
wow.
heads.
Wow, both Joey shaking their heads. No,
Joey gave up.
I don't see why not.
Oh, okay.
Not telling.
He's
they have
back
a
to being Parf. Yeah. Okay.
Correct. A lot to talk about with Joey and Gibber this week.
Oh, then we're going to get after them. We're going to get after them.
Two known bitches.
Okay. Marco and Eric. Excuse me.
Are we refilling him or are we cutting him
no,
off?
No, he's taking a look.
Marco
and Eric, are they the front runners to get the wild card?
We're going to pause one more time. Happy Purim, everyone. We should have started the podcast
right.
by wishing
happy
everyone
Purim.
Happy Purim. Seems like the right thing to do. Also, happy Good Friday. Happy Easter. To the other contingent in the league.
Purim has not ended.
Marco and Eric, looks like they're going to be the front runners for the wild card, unless Chad decides to put someone that doesn't deserve in because he thinks it's good for the league. I don't know.
So Katz and Anand are out. Who's my next match? Those guys are out.
They're going to finish with the most points of any fourth place team. So
yes, they should be in. So what's the question?
What do you think about that?
I think they should be the wild card team. I've said that from the beginning. I think our bracket had all even teams, and so whoever is the fourth team in our bracket should advance. Irrelevant to me since I'm undefeated, really has no...
I guess if they turn it on, they could be a big threat. No? Also no. Wow. Joey,
tough crab.
Joey Kolatch, very tough. Very,
Joey,
very tough.
Joe, let it be known, Joey's number one anything in this league.
I think
he's
really itching to get to the part about him.
Joey, zero doubles championships, zero singles championships. A lot of opinions.
Well... With that, let's bring Joey on, because Joey and Gibber steamrolling. Through pool play, including against Chad, who's been talking a lot of smack.
Yes.
A lot of smack about how he's a favorite and all that nonsense. Joey, come on.
Where's Joey sitting? On my lap?
Joey's going to sit where Gelby's sitting. Gelby's going to just use...
Exit stage right?
Yeah.
This is good.
Are you
Joey?
Sure are you sure they can hear me?
The Let It Be Known podcast. What's the name of our podcast?
The
Lots to Unpack podcast. Wants to welcome Joey Trev.
I can probably just stand up straight. Joey I can stand up. I'm still on camera.
Let it be known. I have two best friends in Angwood.
I'm so short.
I have two best friends in Angwood. We're on a chat called Very Gay Threesome. One of them is Naftali. The other one is Joey. Welcome to the show, Joey.
How can I get into
it's
that?
A pleasure to be here.
How do you feel about being on your first podcast?
Honestly, I don't like looking at myself, but otherwise I feel great.
All right, just look at me.
All right, looking at you. Looking at your skinny legs.
The shadows. Nice kneecaps, though. All right, so do we have questions for Joey? Joey, tell us about you and Gibber.
So,
introduce yourself. Anytime
Chad.
We have a new person, we need to introce.
All right, me and Gibber.
No, give us a little
you?
Background.
Joey Kolatch, what
family,
is the essence of
everyone
Joey
knows
you?
Everyone knows me.
Wait, let's start with how many tennis courts do you have?
Naftali is convinced the entire Brooklyn County that I own more than, I think, one of every surface. And about 85% of people believe him. But it's actually not true.
Do you own grass court?
I own only one. I'm affiliated with two. I own only one, and it's the one that I play on all the time.
Is that yours or daddy's? Please specify.
We have a shared clay court that I let the house that you took a shit in that didn't flush.
Correct. That shit is still sitting there. Let's be very clear.
The shit is still sitting in
this
house.
By the way, this is a very generous man. He knew that there was no water in the house. He knew that it was impossible to flush. He gave me some toilet paper. He said, knock yourself out.
No one has RIP
to that shit. Yeah.
The pipes are starting to break in the house, by the way. Speaking of shit,
you just had raging diarrhea recently.
Yesterday I got hit by a stomach bug.
I also had a stomach bug last week. You might have got it from me.
Did you
eject that stomach bug at his house?
By the way, I went to a, this is a true story, I went to a funeral on Monday, and then I crushed all the kosher food, whatever, you know, the shiva food. And then I had to drive home 90 minutes from Long Island, and I drink a lot of coffee, and so I had two empty big coffee cups sitting on my lap, thinking I was going to puke. I was so sick. Somehow I made it home. As soon as I get home, just started puking my brains out. Next 48 hours, shitting my brains out.
You had no reverse. That's a lot of guys are getting.
This is probably what I had, correct?
People, is this what you had yesterday?
No, I didn't have it, but my friends moved into the bathroom for 2 days.
This is good. So now if you do have it, I can't catch it because I just had it.
But going back to the shiva, the food is for the grievers, not for you. It's for the family that's grieving. Yeah, so they don't have to cook.
This is my family.
It was your family?
Yeah.
Correct. But in your own mind or actually your relatives?
Relatives.
Okay,
distant cousin.
Hey, then is, then
you, think you think I'm going to Long Island? If it's not, what do you think I'm
I do
going?
Think you would eat food at any shiva.
I just
show up at...
I'm reading the obituaries waiting.
And comment on the food. Like, you know...
I'm going around waiting.
A little overcooked. Gotta be honest. A little overcooked.
All right. We're 15
All right. Back onto
we're 15
onto,
minutes into the podcast. We have not discussed anything but diarrhea.
So me and Gibber got a lot of crap for picking Marky.
Wait. Hold on a second.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah.
Who put you over the top, convinced you to pick Marky?
Right before I picked, 20 people stormed me and said, can't pick Skydella. You got. I don't even know who. You were one
me.
Of them.
It was me. I take the credit for it.
I picked Marky. I knew that he would be good in the tougher moments. He's been great. Every match he's gotten better.
Marky, this is your nickname for him?
No, that's his nickname for him. He's
Mark,
known
Marky,
as
Gibber
he goes by
Marky.
Marky. Correct.
Like back when Marky was, was Marky Mark. This is how we used to make the party.
It's like Joey,
so
Marky.
Mix in with the
so like, his best match to date was our match against KC.
I now think you have no chance to win the tournament. He's self-entitled himself Marky?
It's actually Dr. Gibber to you.
Marky.
Side note about
this is gonna be
about Kieran Corcoran. No one talks about KC enough. He smokes the ball. He might be the best player that nobody talks about.
Also has lost dramatic weight. Looks fantastic.
He's fantastic. He's playing amazingly. A fellow litigator will always have a special place for him.
Very good at correcting me in the chat.
Yes. He's excellent. Chad had an off night. Chad was out of it from the... Like, he looked like he just didn't
Chad
care.
Chad was streaming a fourth grade girl's...
Chad was very, very... He was up till 4 a.m. the night before, in his own words, because he was watching a fourth grade girl team get a good defensive stop to win a championship.
And he watched that on repeat?
He was watching it on repeat. He was so amped up by it. He was very tired at the match.
He might get rated like P. Diddy got rated. He's sitting there watching fourth grade girls till 4 a.m. This could be a federal... It's going to be the Homeland Security Department shows up at the Mecca.
I have two issues. So me and Marky are being talked about as potential one seed.
Yes.
Especially if we beat Iwanski and Glasper tomorrow.
I mean, really not, but this is Newman's rankings.
So, well, who has
the
final
say? We're
going
to have Newman on, by the way.
I am going to tank the match tomorrow night because Marky is a known poor handler of pressure. And I think it'd be better for us to lose tomorrow night and be like a 6-8 whatever seed. As opposed to the one seed. And if we're the one seed, everyone's going to be coming for us. And Lerner's going to talk about how we're the fucking worst one seed of all time. So I would rather lose tomorrow night's match, not be considered for the one seed, and fly under the radar as an 8 seed.
Yeah, but what does that do? You're sitting here saying, I'm going to tank the match, so I'm not the one seed.
So hopefully that means we won't
be the one
seed.
We're going to have Newman on. We're going to ask
Newman. Gibber, if you're watching
that.
In between surgeries, Marky...
he's an ENT. You're
the favorite. Don't choke. I mean, it's pretty simple. It's not. You just called him out, which is going to make him more nervous.
He's
a
he will tell you, but the first to tell you, he's doesn't handle pressure well, especially when it's from Jason
Pudzinski. He's a surgeon.
He handles surgery pressure well. It's a different set of pressure. This is way more serious than surgery. The other thing I will say, though, is I'm debuting a new outfit tomorrow night. And I think it's going to get a lot of respect from people.
Are there neon colors involved?
There's neon. There's flowers. There's
Joey, very known for his style on the court. Very flamboyant. Very neon. A lot of pink.
But I back it up.
He backs it up.
Yeah.
Joey, best style in the league. Correct.
Anyway, that's all. That's all I have on our. I do think by the last thing, pool E was by far the hardest pool, in my opinion. Your pool was second.
Who's pool E?
Me, Iwanski, Chad, and Casey. One of the top two pools. Are your pool, yours and mine.
Whatever one has
so
more
whoever wins that pool
hardest.
Undefeated should be the one seed, in my opinion. I didn't think ours was so easy. Oh, you're not with him? Yours is also hard.
I mean, everyone else has three teams. We have five.
We have Shutov Klein as one, too. I mean, if Shutov was...
playing at 100%.
I love Shutov. He had an off night, yeah.
Also, what was Shutov sending in the chat? I was very confused.
I did not get it. One of the things I learned about Shutov, I don't know if I'm allowed to say this, when he's having an off night, he goes behind the curtain. I don't know if he like hits himself or curses at himself, but he goes behind the curtain to compose himself. Then he comes back out for the second set like nothing happened. Have you seen this happen?
I think he's got like one of those, what's it called, those voodoo dolls? It's like a Klein voodoo doll, and he does
he's
to...
a twin, and they switch places.
Yeah, that could be right. He could be a twin. All right, so
Shutov, thank you for your service.
Shutov, thank you for your service.
Thank you for your not service.
Thank you for your not service,
Gelby. You didn't do Israeli. You didn't do the army. You didn't. Neither did you.
There's been a massive disconnect here that the year in Israel is at all equivalent to army service. But
right.
Well, a lot of people think that. It's
don't go to the yeshiva. They don't do anything.
Let it be known. Many friends of mine have gone to Israel and served. Gelby and this
not
friend is
that.
Not three of them.
All
right. What else do we need Gelby for? 20 minutes in.
I think that's. I think that you. Continue.
That's all we got.
We will bring Joey back in a little bit. Thank you very much, Joey.
Thanks
Cole.
For, thanks
to
for joining
the podcast.
Show.
Very good first performance.
By the way, the tequila kicking in.
By the way, we should have discussed me crushing Joey with one arm over the summer. We should bring him back.
Fake tennis court?
Well, it's not fake. It's called red
balls,
pie.
Fake tennis court, and you were only hitting drop shots. All of our other matches were excellent.
Yeah, great matches. Happened to crush you with one arm, though.
Tenify red clay people should be warned the courts there are bullshit.
Well, let's use this as a launching point to call Brian Friedman,
Brian
Newman. I told you the it already hit. Call Brian Newman to give us a little preview of the seedings. He'll be handling the seedings for the tournament.
That sounds fine.
All right, let's give him a call.
Thank you, River Valley Orthodontics, Adar and Alex Vosselman,
and
Adar Schlupman. Finkel.
Call
Dan declined. Thank you very much.
Call declined.
Wow.
Not cool.
Learner, are you trying to call
him? Who?
I know he's calling me. Here we go. Brian Newman, you are live on the podcast. Are you there?
QB6 here. How's everybody doing?
Everyone's doing great, QB6. We have brought you on to give you a little preview of what the seedings may look like coming out of the gold bracket. We just had Joey Kolatch on saying that he intends to throw the match against Coach Joe and Ryan tomorrow night so that Marky Gibber, known mental midget, according to Joey, will be able to handle the pressure better going into the gold bracket. But that being said, what are your little preview points for the tournament as we wrap up pool play?
Look, I think we got to take a step back and understand how the bracket comes together. So I think the one thing we know is who the 16 seed is going to be, because that's going to go to whoever the wild card is. And then, you know, there's a fundamental tenet of round one, which is that we're not going to have anyone play anyone in their division. So unless Marco and Eric, for example, get knocked out of the 16 seed, no one from Group D, that'll be Lerner and Bobby, are going to be the one seed because we want to avoid that rematch. And from there, I created kind of three groups, Group 1, Group 2, Group 3.
What are we avoiding?
And
I missed that.
I'm
saying that the wild card is going to be the automatic 16 seed. So if the wild card is a 16 seed, then whoever's in that same pool won't be the one seed so that the 1 and 16 don't play each other. So
why?
Meaning that two people in the same pool don't play each other.
Why is the wild card automatically a 16 seed?
It's a good question. But probably because it's the last seed in.
That's a
But yeah, he's on a roll. Keep going. Thanks for interrupting. But
no, I missed that. I was someone breached in one of my chats, and I got distracted on my watch, and so I'm back now.
Okay, he's back now. Brian, continue.
All good. So then we have three groups, right? And group one is everyone who finished first in their own group. Group two is everyone who finished second. And group three is everyone who finished third. And so I've got five guys in each of those groups, and then it's about ranking each of those five guys, and then that kind of spits out the order of the bracket. And so, you know, what we care about first is wins, then kind of quality wins, and quality wins is really a bias towards groups D and groups E, because those were the hardest brackets, so they have the most quality wins. And then we kind of look at, you know, sets dropped. And so when I look at, you know, group one, for example, Joey and Mark are 4-0 like everyone else in that group. Are they, to be fair, they will be 4-0 if they beat Ryan and Coach, but they've basically just run over everyone they've played so far. They did drop one set to Doc and Todd, but I think they were up 4-1 in that second set there before they kind of let that one slip away.
Let it be known, I think that Joey Trash will lose, not because he sat here saying he will lose. I believe he will lose to Coach and to Glassberg.
You know, I have not played with Coach, and I've not played with Gibber, but I'm a believer in the transit of property.
Yeah, and, by the way, Coach and Glassberg should have crushed Chad and KC. They played the world's worst first set. I was at that match. Like, they're, you know, they should have steamrolled them also. I think everyone's overrating the win that Joey and Gibber had over Chad and KC, and is overrating that team. I mean, I think Chad is complete trash, for personal opinion. I mean, I think Joey was sitting here trying to, like, KC's so good, and they're so, I don't even see that as a quality win. I don't at all. Love KC to death. Chad, I think, is middle tier in this league. I mean, should have had a pick.
Do you think
maybe.
Chad
I mean,
should have had a pick?
I mean, I don't. I mean, I guess. I mean, there's a steep drop off at some point where it's like you just give whoever a pick. But
the initial bracket here has led to my favorite first round matchup, which is Yeezys and Selby against Chad and KC, because Chad has done nothing but shit on Yeezys for the past several weeks, and you know I think Yeezys has quietly been stewing on that and will absolutely come out and just wreck Chad and KC.
Also, as the acting commissioner, any way to speed up this tournament? It's ungodly slow. I mean, everyone here is dying. I mean, it's been like 2 months already. We're not even in the elimination round. Painful.
You know, I said to the committee a couple of days ago, I said, we just need to have a hard stop date. And if you haven't gotten your matches in by that date, like, we're moving on. But I think at this point, gold is done. And there are two brackets on the silver side that need a few more matches to be played. Now, no one's around for the next couple of weeks anyway with all these holidays, but I think come the week of the 15th, we need to move fast and furious into the elimination round here if we have any hopes of getting this done by Christmas.
Newman, if you or anyone in your family needs any orthodontic work, Rivervale Orthodontics is our sponsor today. Very generous of Adar Finkel, Alex Wasserman, and the Wasserman Finkel family to sponsor the podcast. Would you like to thank them?
I would like to thank them. Good friends of the pod, good friends of ours. And I will say that my son just lost his fifth tooth, and based on how the new ones are coming in, we will be going to Adar in the not too distant future to have to get that all fixed.
We appreciate this. This makes us very happy. Also a known sponsor.
What?
Schluffman
Real Estate Law. Yeah, and Twillery. Use promo code LTU18. Newman, before we let you go, any other matches you're looking forward to based on how you think that the first round will shake out based on the seedings?
Yeah, look, the other match that really jumps off the page is the 5 seed, Peter and Chris, up against the 12 seed, Roman and Carlin. I mean, there's a lot of big personalities on that court.
Who's going against Roman and Carlin?
Peter and Chris.
Peter and Chris, the Flying Dutchman.
Do you think that would even be close?
Yeah, close.
Really?
I think all the matches are going to be close going forward.
You think Roman and Carlin can hold us together mentally?
Yeah.
Really?
I think anyone can win all these matches. I think once you get to the elimination, any team can win every week.
I agree.
I don't see one favorite.
Yeah,
and by the way, everyone is overrating Joey and Gibber. They might win the tournament like anyone might win the tournament. I mean, their big win is over Chad and KC. It's a fucking comical joke.
It's hard to eat at him. It's hard to eat at him. I love it.
I mean, this is the big
one. He can't
win.
Let it go.
We have the toughest bracket. We beat Chad and KC. Fucking okay. You'd be damn Klein.
He's like unfucking. He's unbiased for like 5 minutes.
I mean shit. Fucking toughest bracket.
Well, gentlemen, I'd like to thank you guys for having me on for my segment Totally Hinged with QB6.
By the way, you're very by the way, we appreciate all the work you're doing. What's your record? State your record for the pod.
We are we're now 40 wins and 10 losses.
Very good. That's an
excellent record. Any final comments about me and you coaching K1 football?
Yep, we are going to have the most complicated offense ever devised for a K1 football league. And I'm a little terrified for my son's well-being after seeing that video of you coaching youth basketball.
Yes, that is a very real possibility.
I will be an assistant coach for one of those games.
I would love. We could have Lerner come by for one of those games, right?
At least to give the team a pep talk.
Absolutely.
This is what I'm talking about.
We need to have Lerner come in to give the team a pep talk before a big game.
I'm big on pep talks.
All right, Lerner. I mean, not Lerner. Newman.
Newman, thank you.
Tequila's getting to me. Newman, thank you for your segment. This has been very helpful. We appreciate you as always. Until next time.
Sounds good. I look forward to returning to the court tomorrow night. I'm with my tournament opener with Big D Dan Schluckman.
Big D, no sponsor.
That's right.
Good luck, right. Newman.
Be well, Newman. Take it easy. Good night. All right. Well, moving on from Newman. A lot of knowledge from Newman. Very scientific in how he's going about the
Really taking it seriously.
Right. Who do you think has
some people in the league taking it seriously?
Who do you think has more data? Chad with his mountains of advanced analytics for how he makes up, whatever he makes up, or Newman?
Newman.
Instant response. Instant response.
Anybody but Chad. Newman very, very good at this.
Do you think Newman is doing it on his own, or he took an analyst off a deal?
No, I think Newman's doing this on his own. I think it's very good work. By the way, I enjoy his write-ups. I enjoy the previews.
I feel like there's a team of analysts at Raymond James that are handling the
league. Is that where he works? Yes. Good to know. What is Raymond James? Some big Wall Street?
It's a bank. That's a bank.
Yeah, sounds about right. Very Newman-ish.
All right, well, moving on. Last point on actual tennis is the Silver Tournament. I know that we haven't given Silver a lot of love, but there was an interesting development this past week.
Yeah, your team got bitched around by my team.
My pick for Silver.
Correct.
After myself, couldn't even make it out of pool play with Andrew Gluck.
By the way, I believe you also said you thought you could win the tournament.
Yeah, that didn't happen.
I also said you had no fucking chance. Right, you were sitting here saying, I think I can win, and I said you have no fucking chance.
Andrew Gluck and I, who enjoy playing with each other, did not have a good run. We had a great first set of our first match.
Yeah.
Excellent. 6-1, cruising, and then meltdown from there.
Correct.
So,
are you surprised?
Enough at myself?
I'm
no.
Not.
Yeah, not surprising
not surprised
at all.
Just call it from the beginning.
Yeah, so Lilling and Leon,
but
and
Lilling
I've been saying
and Leon,
this,
yeah, absolutely. They had
I think I've been saying this for a while. To me, they're the favorites. So Lilling and Leon, if it's not for Marco and Eric, they're in gold. And so they're equivalent to me of like a Somat Goldberg, or they should have been, in my mind, a wild card team in gold. And so it's just that simple. Like, that team should be the favorite in the silver tournament. Any team that should have been in gold is a favorite.
Well, we're gonna call into Matt Lilling, hoping that he picks up, to give his comments on what he thinks about his chances in the silver tournament.
That sounds good to me.
Let's hope he picks up.
Very hot.
Honestly, I'm more comfortable than I have been in the last couple of
leaning
times.
Away from it.
Unavailable.
Lower the fire. Yes, I would love you to. If you guys didn't hear me at the beginning of the podcast, I'm currently the pool champion. It is March 25th, 2024.
Here we go.
I'm 3-2
on
Natalie.
He's calling
in. Oh, we got a call.
Hello?
Matthew
yes.
Lilling. Welcome
Matthew
to Lilling. Unpack. How
are you,
sir?
You are live on the pod.
Oh, hey, guys. Thanks for having me.
Tell us a little bit about yourself. Tell us about your family, what you do for a living, how long you've been in the league.
I've been in the league since the beginning. And I was I've come a long way. I was not a good tennis player when this whole thing started. I don't think I'm still probably not that great, but I've gotten a lot better.
Correct.
And it's just been a lot of fun playing with all you guys. So I'm thrilled to be on this hyper localized tournament edition podcast here.
I'm very happy. So I learned this week Matt Lilling was not a listener to our podcast. And then when I spoke to him, I'm like, oh, he goes, "Oh, you mentioned me on the podcast?" I go, "Yes, I've been touting you guys as my favorite." And then he started to listen
and
to
then,
the podcast.
Well, Littling sent me some smack talk this week saying he was very upset with me that
yes,
I did not pick him to win.
Yes, he learned this from me.
Oh, he learned
this
from me? I thought he learned
not watching the podcast.
No, I thought he listened to the podcast.
And then after he finished watching the podcast, he asked for some tabs. He goes, "It's too long. Got to put some tabs so I can see my, you know, silver part."
Yeah, so I can skip right to the silver.
No,
that's
you
true.
Must watch our entire podcast. That's not how we want to work it.
We give no previews.
To me, you did mention silver in like the last 2 minutes and 30 seconds of the last episode. So.
Matt Lilling, if your kids need any orthodontic work, Rivervale Orthodontics is our sponsor today. It's Alex Vossman's wife, Adar Finkel. Fantastic orthodontist. She is our sponsor today. So if you or anyone in the family need any orthodontic work, you will go to Rivervale Orthodontics.
But we brought Matt on to talk about silver since he did have some comments, some choice words for me this past week. And we just mentioned that he had a huge win this past week against Park and Lee to cement his status as a front runner for silver. Matt, what do you have to say about the silver tournament so far and what you think the tournament will how it will unfold as we exit pool play?
I think that what makes the silver tournament a lot different than gold is that there's a really wide range of talent and skills in this tournament. And in gold, it's just a lot more, it's a lot narrower. Everyone knows how to play doubles. Everyone's pretty good. In silver, there's some really talented players, and then there's some guys who could still improve. But I think what's going to make the biggest difference in that tournament is who plays the best doubles, who plays the best team.
This is a very political response. This is very political. There are guys in silver that cannot fucking play tennis at all. There are guys in silver that I sit around and I think to myself, how the fuck did the league turn into this? No offense to the people that I might be talking about, but there are some people.
Lily's a nice guy. He doesn't want to talk bad about other people.
Correct. He's being very generous with his comments. I mean, the league this year, the bottom.
Diplomatic.
He's diplomatic. I'm just going to be a straight shooter. Correct. You're saying it very nicely, but there are some people that are 10x worse than you when you first started in the league, Lilling.
True. But, you know, what I will say is, like, when we played Park and Lee this past week, who Gelby picked as the favorites, they're really good players. But I think what separated me and Leon this past week is that Leon and I communicate really well. We set each other up for the putaways. You know, we don't miss a lot of shots, and we play as a team. We have good strategy that's coherent and easy to implement. And I think a lot of guys are just going out there and trying to play tennis.
Side note, Leon, very good friend of mine, invited me to his pool party this summer. Love Leon. Been in the league for many years also.
Shabbat
invited? Also a member of Red Clay. I have not been invited to Shabbat.
You're invited to me for Shabbat.
You've never invited me to Shabbat.
I'm inviting you now.
I will come to Shabbat.
Lerner will be at your house. Shabbat,
I will.
So.
If I get sick from overeating the food or neurovirus or whatever happened to me, I'll be mad, but I will come to Shabbat. We will do a podcast from Shabbat. We will do a podcast at his Shabbat.
Matt, you and I have played together once this past year. I did not make out of a pool play with Andrew Gluck. What are your thoughts on that?
I mean, I think you guys are some really nice guys. I don't know. I don't know who you guys lost to. I don't know if it was close. I wasn't there. But I think I played with both of you, and you know, there's a game in there somewhere. You just got to put some time into it.
You know the Key and Peele sketch where they have the Obama translator?
Yeah.
Matt needs one of those.
What game does Gelby have that's in there somewhere?
It's definitely the two-handed backhand volley.
It's very deep.
Wait, deep. Naftali, how do you feel about my backhand, my backhand two-handed backhand slice?
The chop.
The chop.
Gelby is worse at tennis than showing up on time for this podcast. I mean, Gelby
is saying a lot.
I mean, for the love of God.
All right, Matt, thanks for popping in. I know that you were a little tight on the schedule, but we appreciate your contribution nonetheless.
All right, thanks, guys.
Any final words about the tournament or the league?
What's that?
Yeah, we're just desperate for material. All right, we appreciate you. Thanks for calling in.
Thanks, Matt.
All right, see you later.
Bye. All right. Well,
all right, any league drama that we can get into now?
Yes.
After wasting
we've
minutes?
Been avoiding the Sandeep drama, and I think that it's come time
to
unpack it. There's lots to unpack with Sandeep drama.
Can you refresh my memory on it?
It's old news.
You think it's old news? We're grasping at straws. Do you want to make any comments on the Sandeep drama? Okay, we'll give the short version.
I don't even remember what happened. I've been so far removed from the chat. The tournament has just become so fucking slow and boring. And
Sandeep entered the league. Sandeep entered the league. Mid-year. He's from.
Just got back from the Bahamas. I fucking crushed Scarf in golf, and he's like a golfer. That guy's. I don't golf. I try and golf. I'm not a good golfer. He's a golfer. That'd be like him beating me in singles. I crush him in golf.
What was the score?
First round, I shot a 94. He shot a 96. But I also get, I'm a 17-7. He's like a 12 handicap. So I also get many strokes, but I beat him straight up. He goes, oh, we're only going to play golf once. We're here with our wives. We can't. So as soon as I crush him, he makes another round. We rebook another round. I go out and I fucking beat him again.
What was the score on that one?
I couldn't tell you. We didn't count the score. But this time I beat him with the strokes. So I didn't beat him straight up. I beat him with the strokes. Tied on 18. He choked. It was fucking amazing. Just feel like, I mean, he fucking shanked it out of bounds in the drive. I was like, woo!
Were you talking smack in the backswing?
Then I also shanked my drive out of bounds to match it. He was the first out of bounds. I was like, I took a 6-iron instead of a driver, shanked mine anyway out of bounds. Known bitch. Still good enough to win, though. Fantastic. So I'm currently known as DL1. He's JS2. Also, I'm currently known as DL1 and Naftali, since he's lost me in pool. It will be Naftali Schuss too, so he's NS2. Known fucking champion over here.
Sorry. You beat him how many times straight tonight?
We're going to skip the Sandeep drama. I just don't have the energy for it.
Oh, we'll get into the Sandeep drama next time if we are really...
Then it'll be a month. Yeah.
All right. Is there anything else you want to get into, off the court stuff?
I want to know.
I don't remember. It was just big.
Oh, the Chad Venmo account.
I couldn't tell you.
Rumors have it that Chad's Venmo account has a lot of figures. A lot of figures in it. Seven figures?
I think that's probably correct. I don't remember.
That's a lot of basketball texting.
Joey sent him at least seven figures himself. I mean, Englewood contingent, very generous.
But let it be known, our JCC-based travel basketball team, fourth grade travel basketball team, defeated the CMEC fourth grade Tenafly team.
Uninterested in that. Also,
with Chad coaching and going psychotic at the game.
I'm really not interested in anything else. We're capping this. I want to play Naftali and pool again right now.
All right. Well, with that, we're going to wrap it up.
Thank you to Schluffman.
Thank you to Schluffman. Schluffman Real Estate Law.
Home closings. Also,
Alex Wasserman and his wife, Adar.
Correct.
Or she's lovely really the orthodontist.
She is
Rivervale Orthodontics.
She happens to be the top orthodontist in the tri-state area.
And Twillery.com. Get your threads from Twillery.com.
And Kosher Nosh needs to get some love.
Promo code LTU18.
Like a co-sponsor.
Kosher Nosh, owned by Ari Starkman.
I would like to say a couple more things before we sign
off. Go ahead.
Bobby and I will win the tournament. That's number one. That might happen in July at this pace. Honest assessment. Like, I don't know how this thing is getting finished. People have spring breaks and traveling and all this crap. Number three.
There is no number three.
Oh, that was two or three?
No, that was two.
Depends how you count.
He's going to win the tournament.
Which will happen in July.
I was like, I will win this tournament. This will be in July. Thank you for watching. We love you. We appreciate you. And thank you to Better Sports Production. Matty Deutsch, we love you. Got money, y'all can fancy and trash it. I'm a big time.